was called him the Messiah. As I was quoting to you this morning, Matthew brought Jesus out as a Messiah. Mark brought him out as a wonder worker, working miracles in the church. Luke brought him out as the Son of Man, John, the Son of God. I could go ahead on, but thank God tonight, Matthew classified Jesus as the Messiah. Looking into the ninth chapter, turn with me to a familiar passage of scripture we've read. You've heard it preached, but I hope we go a little different route. The ninth chapter of Matthew, the 20th verse, and behold, a woman which had a disease with an issue of blood 12 years came behind him and touched the hem of his garment. And she said within her heart herself, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be made whole. But Jesus turned him around, and when he saw her, he said, daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith hath made thee whole. And the woman was made whole from that hour. She was made whole. Whole. I mean every whit whole from that hour. Disease that was incurable. No healing, no cure. Say, well, Brother Dobbs, you don't know what the doctors have diagnosed my case. There's no cure. There's no such thing with God is no cure. There's healing in the atonement by 39 stripes. There's 39 major diseases, and you're healed by his stripes. How many believe that? I believe it was one of the writers said, where Isaiah said over there, he said he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace is upon him, by whose stripes we were healed. We are healed. Peter, come along. And said, by whose stripes we are healed. We are healed. One was past tense. One was looking to Calvary 500 and something years ahead. And one was looking back to Calvary, because one was looking for it to come by the stripes. And one had done saw the stripes. And one had been through the stripes. And he knowed it was real. Peter knowed it was real. He'd walked in his shadow. He'd been with Jesus. He'd been in the fiery trials. And I mean, he'd been in the furnace with Jesus. He had done him. He cursed. He swore. He'd done everything in the book. But let me tell you something. When Peter come through his trial and come through the furnace and got the Holy Ghost, you can follow Peter's record. Thank God he was strong all the way and made it through and went through Pentecost and preached one of the greatest messages in the streets of Jerusalem. And 3,000 souls were saved. I mean, on the street corner, got on the next street corner and preached another message at 5,000 more souls were saved. 8,000 souls added to the New Testament church that Brother James was the pastor of that church. How many believe that's a real church upon this rock? Upon this rock, Jesus said, I'll build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. How many believe he's got a church? He's got a church, and that church is going to come out of a church. Ezekiel seen it, the boneyard. He saw the boneyard. It was full of dry bone. But Ezekiel said, these bones will live again. He prophesied them bones would live again, and them bones come out, and them bones begin walking around, and sinews come upon them, flesh come upon them. He prophesied these bones will live again. Honey, I'm prophesying tonight that your bones are going to rise and going to live again. Clap your hands. I feel the victory. Brother, this woman had been to Calvary. You don't know what it's like to maybe go through what she went through with. She was busted. She was disgusted at the world because she spent all her money. When I say all her money, she spent every dime and dollar she had upon physicians. And I'm not fighting physicians. I'm not fighting doctors, because I say this and still say it. If you've not got the faith to be healed, you better find you a good specialist and not a quack. How many believe that? Say amen. Praise God. So she heard about it. She'd been to the doctor, spent all of her money. It was all gone, and it was exhausted. She knew what it was like to go in the doctor's office and the nurse walk out and look her in the eye and said, I have a note here on my desk from the doctor. Said he cannot see you no more until the bill is caught up and brought up to date and you bring some more money. She said, but I don't have no more money. He said, well, I can't give you another drop of blood. She had a blood disease. And that blood disease, white corpuscles, was drinking up the red corpuscles, and she losing her strength. Honey, the life is within the blood. Whether you want to believe it or not, you start losing your blood, and you lose your life. The life is within the blood. And if you get the right kind of blood, you will get eternal life. If you get the blood of Jesus Christ in your heart, you will have eternal life, and you'll shout and praise God forever, and he that believeth upon me shall never die. Though he were dead, yet shall he live again. Would you clap your hands? I feel the victory. Brother, she'd been through that and known what it was like to go to the doctor and just keep spending and getting another pint of blood. My wife's father, mother was dying with cancer, and I'll never forget what my father-in-law said. In the last hour or two that she lived, he looked at my wife and said, we pumped blood in her and pumped blood in. It went on to last a day or two, another pint, and cost so much. And he looked at my wife and he said to keep her another day or another night. I'm good of mine to go get another pint, to just keep her another night, to just have her with me around another night. But you can't go on and on and on forever like that. There's an end to that. How many believe that? If you're rich, you can't stand that. It'll soon bleed you to death financially. And if you don't have no money, you'll soon get exhausted in your body, and you can't stand no more of that. Honey, to lose your blood, you lose your life. You've got to get filled with the blood and get a shot of the blood and a shot of Jesus to let your blood come on up. My God, you that's got high blood pressure, he's a blood equalizer. You that's got low blood, he can bring it up. You that's got high blood, he can bring it down. He can heal your pressure tonight. I said tonight, your blood, life is within your blood, and Jesus can heal a blood disease. Don't tell me he can't. He can. He'll make it whole. Praise God. She was exhausted. But come out. He said, I can't see you no more. You'll have to come back some other time with some money, or I can never help you no more. It's all over. Well, she spent all she had, sold everything she'd had, borrowed ever from everybody she could borrow, couldn't borrow no more. She couldn't think of no angle to get any more money. And the doctor definitely had to have that stuff you count out across, the count of the money. But let me tell you what she done. I believe with all my heart, she run into the little boy that had to, had them five loaves and them two fishes. She run into him with a bag, standing on the street corner crying, because she was exhausted, going to die, sent home to die. How many people's come to this church that's been sent home to die without hope, without any mercy? Let me tell you something. Jesus is still in the mercy seat, and if you'll let him tonight, he'll come passing by. He'll touch you on your brow. He'll heal your disease. I don't care what you got, what kind of infirmity you got, what kind of disease you got. He can make you whole from the sole of your feet unto the crown of your head. Jesus Christ is alive tonight and got the keys for your deliverance and wants to deliver you right now. Clap your hands for the victory. No doubt she looked at the little boy with the had that bag in his hand. He was so excited. She said, son, where are you going? And he looked at her crying. And she was no doubt crying because she was going to die. No hope, been sent home. How many doctors has told people that you're going to die and not live. Oh, honey, they've come to me by the hundreds. And it's not me, but it's God that told me, the doctor told me I had 3 months to live or 30 days to live. If I had any papers to get fixed up, get them fixed up, because I couldn't make it long. And honey, we pray for them, and God does the healing. God does the healing. And honey, they're still alive tonight. Listen, man don't know everything. God gives and God takes. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And if you're one of them kind tonight and the doctors have pronounced a debt upon you, don't forget. Get this life beyond death, and God gives life. He's the author and the finish of my faith, who for the joy endured the cross and sit back down at the right hand of the Father. He's walking the aisle tonight wearing that seamless robe, anointed with power. Praise God. Steve went over to China and come back with hepatitis. No cure for hepatitis. Something he'd eat and contacted in China and come back and turned his eyeballs as yellow as a pumpkin. I mean, he went to the doctor, and one doctor sent him to another doctor, and five or six specialists come in and looked at him. And I'll never forget the report. There was a lady doctor over all the other men doctors that come and looked at Steve at last and told, this is what she told Steve. Son, she said, first of all, we don't even know how to doctor their kind of hepatitis. And said, if you've got any arrangements to make or any kind of papers to legal, papers to get filled out and fixed up, said, you better go home and tend to it, because you won't be around too long. Hallelujah. Steve come to me, told me the report, what five doctors had told him, that she was a sixth doctor, had turned in that case. And something spoke to me, just like God spoke to me tonight here in the church. Spoke to me, said, don't eat another mouthful. Don't drink another drop of water until you hear from heaven. Push back your plate. There's a place, honey, if you want something from God, you can fast and you can pray until you get an answer from God. God's still in the prayer answering business. I don't care what they say. I don't care what the doctors diagnose. God still answers prayer and works miracles in the church. He's a miracle worker. He believes in miracles. I believe in miracles. You believe in miracles. And these signs shall follow them that believe in my name. They'll cast out devils. They'll heal the sick. They'll cleanse the lepers. They'll raise the dead. They'll preach the gospel to the poor. And you'll speak with new tongues and shout and praise God, and you'll be delivered. The best way to get healed is just come out of your seat or praising God, leaping for joy and running the aisles and find the Holy Ghost and let God overrun the devil and get the devil out the way, and God bring the holy deliverance to your life. That's the best way to get delivered if you got something. So I never forget, they sent him home, fill out the papers. He come to me and told me, and I said, God spoke to me not to eat another mouthful. And we went the third morning, I believe it was the third morning, and we went without any food or water, without a drop of food or drop of water. And just before daylight, God spoke to me, woke me up, and spoke to me. He said, get a hold of Steve. And said, pray for him now. I'm ready to heal him. I'm ready to heal him. I'm not through with him. I've got a work for him to do. He's got hepatitis, and doctors can't cure it. Man can't heal it, but he said, I can. He said, you use your faith, lay hands on him, and you get him delivered. Hallelujah. I said, called him up at crack of daylight, and I said, Steve, come over to the house. He said, what is it? I said, God told me to pray for you, and he was going to heal you. And I don't believe it took him 2 minutes to be over there. He was dressed and over to the house in about 2 minutes, and me and my wife, we prayed for him, laid hands on him, and first thing come first, I took authority over that demon of hepatitis that had got on him, and I told him he had to come out. He couldn't stay there no longer. Let me tell you, God give us power to use the power to heal the sick, cast out the devil, and raise the dead, and preach the gospel. I'm doing this tonight. That's just what I'm doing. Clap your hands. I feel the victory. I told that demon to hold his peace, but come out of him, get off of him, and let him go free. And when I got through praying, I said, son, now you can go to every doctor you went to and go to all of them you want to go to, and they won't find no trace of hepatitis in your body, because Jesus of Nazareth, that Nazarene, has passed by and put a healing upon your body. Come on, saints. God, Jesus still heals. He's a great healer. He'll heal anything. Praise God. And he went to this doctor, and the rest of them was out. And they told him they'd be back within a couple of hours, him to come back. He wanted all of them to see it. And they all examined him, looked at him, and said, what did you do? He said, well, it's like this, doc. He said, I got a praying parents, a mom and a dad that knows how to pray. And said they pushed their plate back and didn't eat another mouthful and went on a long fast. And my dad called me up, laid hands on me, and prayed for me. Said, that's all that's been done. He said, I don't know what you've done, but keep on doing what you've done. Said, let me tell you, we don't find no trace of hepatitis in your body. And said, we don't believe you're going to die, but we believe you're going to live. Let me tell you something. We got power to walk over them devils, over them sicknesses, over them afflictions, and come out victoriously. How many believe if we will touch the hem of that garment, we'll be made whole? Honey, you got to touch God. You got to touch Jesus. If you can get to where Jesus is, touch the hem of his garment and you'll be healed. Clap your hands for the victory. Now, they said there's one more. That lady doctor, you've got to go before her. And she said, this is the most rarest case that I've ever had in all my career. 3 days ago, I hold the x-rays, and it's there. 3 days later, you come back, and it's not there. She said, all I know, a miracle has took place. Helamo kamatai. Oh, saints of God, I'm preaching miracles tonight. I'm preaching touch the border of his garment and you'll be healed. I don't care who you are. If you press on and you'll go on and you'll keep on keeping on, you'll get it after a while. You may not get it tonight. You may not get it tomorrow. But if you'll hold on and keep on keeping on and pressing on, after a while, you will touch God and you will touch Jesus and you'll get the border of his garment and you will be instantly healed. Clap your hands. I feel the victory. Praise God. In the name of Jesus. Now I'm to the main part of the message tonight. That little boy said, hey, why are you crying? Just bear with me just a minute. With my imagination. She said, because the doctor said I was going to die and not live. Didn't have any more money to go back to him. Said, there's no hope. He said, lady. She said, yes, sir. Said, come follow me. I've heard out here by the Sea of Galilee, there's a man on that hillside that fed 5,000 men beside the women and all the children, and said he's turned the water to wine, and said the blind is seeing and the lame is walking, and said every pool around Jerusalem has been emptied out, and said that man's out there and thousands are getting healed, thousands are getting saved. Do you want to be healed? Come go with me, lady. Let's go to the meeting. Let's go where the Galilean is. Let's go where the Nazarene is. That man that could walk the water, that man could talk to the wind, that man could speak and the winds would be calm and the waves would quit jumping. Thank God he's a man to come in your life tonight. He's a man that can heal. He's a man that can speak and you'll be healed. When the doctor says you can't make it, you will make it. All you got to do is have faith in God. Use your faith in God. Clap your hands. I feel the victory. You know, some people, when you tell them what's wrong with you, first thing they say, you better contact the doctor. You better get a hold of the doctor. And you know what the doctor will tell you? I better operate. Let me pick up the phone and get this thing set. We'll get the x-rays going and we'll perform surgery. And my wife said something this morning, made a lot of sense. She said, you can't cut pain out. I don't care where you go, there ain't a doctor living that can cut pain out. How many believe tonight? He may leave more pain there than you had, but he can't cut pain out. How many believe this? You know what he can cut? You know what God can cut out? God can cut pain out. He can cut out soreness. He can cut out sickness. He can cut out everything that's went wrong with you. Do you hear me tonight? Do you want to sit there and die? Do you want to dry up? Or do you want to rise or pick up your bed and walk with faith in God? If you ain't got faith in God, you're going to die anyhow. How many believe that? If you got the faith of a grain of a mustard seed, you'll move your mountains. You'll pluck up your sycamore trees. You'll divide your waters. Thank God, I feel the victory tonight, and I feel multitudes of being made whole by the spoken word of the Holy Ghost, and I feel God tonight bringing deliverance to you. Clap your hands for the victory. Now we come to the serious part. Mustering the faith. Now, this look silly. You can tell some people what God told you to do, and they'll laugh at you. They'll say, I don't believe that. I don't see how that would do any good. Jesus told her, God told her, to go touch the hem of the garment. Not go pull his coat off of him, tear a piece of it off, but go touch the hem of the garment. He told her that, and she meant to do it. If God tells you to run, walking won't do. Whatever God tells you to do to get your healing, you've got to do it. And everybody in the church may be jumping up, running off, and leaving you, and you're still sitting there. Honey, if God told you to do a certain thing, if everybody laughs, they poke fun at you, you say they're going to watch me. I don't care. You say they're going to talk about me. They're going to talk about you. Anyhow, give them something to talk about. Thank God for victory tonight. I'm going to the victory side. I'm going over to the other side. I'm going to come out with my deliverance. How many more deliverance tonight? How many going to walk by faith? How many going to live by faith? The just shall live by faith. What kind of faith? Faith in God will make you whole. He'll do it. And Brother Dobbs has been pastoring his church 30 years. I believe it will. Now listen, pastor in this church, nearly 31 years, preaching 40, nearly 41 years, and I'm going to tell you something. I'm not condemning them, but I'm giving God the glory where I'm at tonight. While I'm sitting there, never has a doctor's, a physician's knife in 40 years touched my body for an operation. God has kept me. I've seen the time that I was sicker than I believe anybody in the congregation, but I had to come out of it. I had to get a hold of God and let God make me whole. I didn't want no operation. I didn't condemn it, but I didn't want it. I thought the easiest way out was what I was preaching. I was preaching faith and live by faith, try my faith, and honey, it works. It's worked for me for 40 years, and if you want to try it and get aboard tonight, it'll work for you. Thank God. I'll never stand here and preach to you that I've never been sick in 40 years. I'd be lying to you, but I'll tell you, in 40 years, Jesus has healed every infirmity and every sickness that I had, and I'm still walking by faith, and I'm going to live by it, and thank God I got the victory tonight. I'm walking over demons, walking over devils, walking over sicknesses and affliction, and I'm still healed. I don't care what kind of pain I have in my body. I'll say I'm like Job. Though God slay me, yet I'll trust in the Lord, and I'll wait till my change comes. He's coming to change. He's coming to change. And God will send deliverance to your house. Clap your hands for victory. Now, she got to the serious point, the embarrassing point. Get there in the crowd, shoved her back. Get out of here. Get out of here. I was before you. She said, you ain't going to offend me, and you ain't going to hurt my feelings. I have come for my healing tonight. Let me tell you people something. If you're desperate and you're serious and you don't want to die, you don't want to die and you want to live, you can live with your faith in God. Don't give up. Keep on keeping on and fight as long as there's a breath in you. Let me tell you something. Fight as long as you've got a fist. And if you lose your fist, use your nub and nub him a little bit. How many believe that? Thank God. Oh, hallelujah. And if he gets in your way, the devil, kick him as long as you've got a foot. If you lose your foot, walk on him. Thank God. If bite him as long as you've got teeth. If you lose your teeth, gum him until the devil gets out the way. He's a real God. You can have enough faith in God. I'm not going to turn it loose. I'm going on. I'm going to stand true. I'm going to stand. Jesus said, pass him by. He'll heal me tonight. Come on. Do you want to be made whole? Will thou be made whole? Do you want to be delivered tonight? That Nazarene is in this church house. Clap your hands for real, real victory. She said, if I can get right under here and ease over here and ease through here and ease a little further, I'm close enough nearly to touch the border of his garment. I'll touch it. After a while, I press my way on until I touch it. And they said, get back. She said, I am determined to touch it. And there it is. I've touched it. Hallelujah. And when she touched it, she felt that blood disease be stanched on the inside. And she felt that healing virtue flow from Calvary through her body. And she felt that infirmity leave her body. And she felt sickness go and felt virtue come in and felt the Son of God make her whole. Wilt thou be healed tonight? Oh, there's a lot of you tonight that needs deliverance of pain that the doctors can't do. But don't you forget one thing. My God can do it without a knife. He can do it without an operation. All he got to do is speak the word, and the word will come to pass. Clap your hands for the real victory. Closing while my organist comes tonight on this. Listen, I'm persistent. Everybody knows me. Said I'm persistent. You got to be persistent. You'll never get to heaven without being persistent. Some of them says I'm stubborn. If I am, I'm stubborn for God. You can be stubborn for God or get pushed out of the ballpark. How many believe you ain't going to push me no worse? I didn't come here running, and I'm not going to leave here running. How many believe that? I was here before some of you come. And if you don't like my looks, you just have hit Commonwealth. How many believe that? Say amen. Some of you ain't won no beauty contest. You say, well, I know some people don't like you. Yes, and I know some don't like you. You ain't won no popularity contest yourself. How many believe I'm preaching the truth tonight? My God, wake up. I wake up tonight. It's time to we bind together. We're an army, and we can pray one for another. One can put 1,000 to flight, or two of us can put 10,000. Clap your hands. I feel me some victory tonight. I feel healing sweeping this tabernacle, and Jesus can make every one of you ever withhold at one time. There's a cloud over the tabernacle by day and a pillar of fire by night. I'm under the cloud and I'm under the pillar. Clap your hands. This is real. This is real. Closing on this thought, when she touched him, she jumped. She felt. We're not healed by feelings. We're healed by faith. Because your feeler will get broke down. I've had mine broke down. How many believe that? Say amen. You're healed by faith in God. I got prayer. Yeah, Brother Dobbs is the other night, and he prayed the prayer of faith for me, and I left, and I got worse. You was going by your feelings. You can't go by your feelings. You got to go by faith. And when the devil makes you worse, say, devil, I got prayer, and God made me whole, and I'm going to claim victory until I go to be with the Lord, or I shout victory out of it. I'll win it or I'll lose it. I'm not going down. I'm going to rise, and I'm going to keep going. Saints of God, where are you at tonight? Where is your faith? If you got the faith of a grain of a mustard seed, you'll move your mountains. You'll divide your waters. You'll pluck up your sycamore trees. Thank God for real faith. Thank God for real faith. It'll work every time. Hallelujah. Where doubt comes in, a faith comes in and runs doubt out. If unbelief or doubt ever knocks on your door, send faith to the door. It won't be nobody there. Thank God that if you got the faith of a grain of a mustard seed, you'll move that mountain. You'll pluck up that sycamore tree. You'll divide them waters. You'll come over on dry ground and you won't die. Did you hear me? You say, what if I do die? You'll go to heaven. If you're saved, that's what'll happen. How many believe God delivers two ways? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord tonight. Is he there? He turned around and the Son of God by the name of Jesus of Nazareth stopped. Didn't pray for another one. The multitudes were trying to turn around and say, hey, somebody. He says, somebody has touched me. Peter said, what do you mean with these thousands thronging thee? These thousands that shoving thee. What do you mean somebody's touched me? He said, they didn't have the touch, but this one that touched me had the real touch. That faith had rung the bell of heaven, and Jesus felt that faith come through him. He said, I've never seen such great a faith, no, not in Israel. She had the faith that brought the virtue and healed that blood disease. No longer was she sick, but she was healed. And you can leave this church tonight, ever went made whole, while they sang the chorus. Tonight's your night. Stand to your feet. Every one of you, stand to your feet. You say, I can't, I'm sick. That's the way to get healed. Rise, pick up your bed and walk. That's the best way to get healed.
I now am free. Somebody,
I tell you what God's told me to do, and I'm going to do it. I'm going to obey the Lord. Prophet had it in his shadow. Peter had it in his shadow. Paul had it in his anointed aprons and handkerchiefs. How many know what I'm talking on here tonight? Jesus had it in his garment. Thank God Paul got it in some of his garment. How many believe it tonight is real? Jesus told me to stand here. And you ain't got to push, you ain't got to knock, no, you ain't got to pull. But all you got to do is touch the anointed, this old anointed coat. Thank God I've got a hold of it again. God told me to wear it. He no more come out time. God told me to wear it tonight, and everybody that wants to be healed. I don't mean play around. Maybe I'll get healed, or maybe I won't. Everyone that wants to be healed, I don't care where you're standing,
somebody
come and touch my garment. Come and touch it tonight. And take your seats.
I was blind.
Come on, saints. Touch that garment. Go your way.
See.
Come on. Touch your garment. Touch your garment and be made whole. Touch that garment tonight.
When Jesus loves,
come on, saints. Touch it tonight. Touch it and be healed. It's full of the Spirit of the Lord.
Somebody touch me. Somebody touch me.
Come on, saints. Touch the
hem
of that garment tonight.
I was blind, but
remember, you're
going to
be healed when you touch it. You're
going to
be healed. You're going to be healed. You're going to be healed. Thank God for victory tonight. I felt it.
When
Jesus
found me.
Thank God for victory. Thank God for victory.
And since he found me.
Thank God for victory. Praise God for victory. Praise
somebody
God. The name of Jesus.
Oh,
touch my garment.
Touch me.
Come on, saints.
Oh,
Peter got it in his shadow. I've got it in my garment tonight. care what you need, God is going to give it to you tonight. Name it, claim it.
When Jesus
come on, touch it. Touch it. Touch it. Get what you want from God.
I now can
touch it. Touch it.
Somebody
that ain't the only time tonight that you're going to touch it.
Somebody touch me.
Come on by and touch it. You got to leave healed. I don't care what's wrong with you tonight. You're going to leave healed. You're going to leave healed.
Oh, I was
come on.
In darkness.
You're going to leave healed tonight.
When Jesus found me.
Touch that garment tonight. Touch the hem of that garment.
Touch me.
Shabba-ba-ba.
So
come on, that's it. Brother Beverly, that's it. That's it.
Somebody touch me.
Shabba-ba-ba-ba-ba.
Oh, somebody touch me.
Somebody touch me.
I was blind.
Somebody
but touch me. Praise His name.
Somebody
I now can
me.
See.
Somebody touch me.
Oh, I was
somebody
in
touch
darkness.
Somebody's
when
fixing
Jesus
to touch me. Somebody's
me.
Fixing to touch me.
But since He found me, I now am free.
Be healed of sugar diabetes. Go your way. God told me.
Somebody touch me.
Oh, I was blind. But
God told me to do this. That was for the healing of your body. No one sitting, everyone standing, just for a few minutes tonight. Hallelujah. Very few more of these offerings we'll have to take up in 1992. It'll come to a close. I'll start a new beginning, and God will give me a new shot. And when God gives me a new shot to take up new offerings, He's going to give you new money to put in the offerings. How many believe you're going to overflow? How many believe God's going to put your mouth under the spot where the glory is coming out? Now, I'm going to do what I'm going to do, and I'm going to do it.
Thanks
quick.
For watching this awesome video clip. If this sermon has been a blessing to you, help us out as we put more of these videos online. It takes thousands of dollars to put these videos online. Please go to PaxtonRevivalCenter.com and donate to help us spread the gospel to everyone in the world. Go to PaxtonRevivalCenter.com.